Evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Sam Loth. I'm the coordinator for the neighborhood organization known as the 18th Wonder. The 18th Wonder is an acronym for the 18th Ward, which is the southwest neighborhoods of the city of Reading. They include Millmont, Oak Brook, and Wyomissing Park. We're here today to tell you about this 18th Wonder Neighborhood Improvement Association, and we are also here to invite you to a public meeting which will take place this coming Thursday evening, July 20th, at 7 p.m. At the Reading Housing Authority Conference Room, which is located on Hancock Boulevard in Oak Brook, 400 Hancock Boulevard. It's at the corner of Hancock Boulevard and Liggett Avenue, actually down the hill from Berks Catholic High School, in case you are familiar with that and not with the area I'm talking about. This area houses not only the Oak Brook Homes, which are beautiful public housing. It also borders on the neighborhood of Wyomissing Park, which have a very large number of beautiful garden apartments overlooking the little valley where West Reading begins, and also looking down onto Lancaster Avenue. And we have the Reading Truck Body business there. We have the Masano Auto Group there, the Berks Catholic High School there, the Oak Brook Homes. It's an interesting neighborhood. On the other side of Lancaster Avenue is Millmont. And we have in Millmont a very interesting makeup of different types of homes, different types of family, really worker homes, small individual family homes that were built to house the many thousands of people that worked in the manufacturing plants and the housing, various different plants that manufactured goods, foods, the building of the railroads, the engines, and so on. Over the years. And that neighborhood also has its own unique character and flavor. The main highways in between are your commercial corridors, and for one reason or another, they have adopted various different, they've attracted various different types of businesses over the years, and I'll go into all of that. I have a slide here I'd like to put up that explains the information that I want you to have for this public meeting, this town hall public meeting that is going to take place, again, I'll say on Thursday evening at the Reading Housing Authority. And if you look at the map, you'll see in the center at the top there, Tom Masano Auto Group. And then right up next to it is the Berks Catholic High School. Directly across the street from the Tom Masano Auto Group building is where the meeting will take place. On Hancock Boulevard at Liggett Avenue. And what we're going to do is we're going to have consultants that are schooled at listening to you, the general public, and we want you to attend this meeting if you are a resident of one of these three neighborhoods. If you're a resident of Millmont or Oak Brook or Wyomissing Park, or if you're a business owner in one of these neighborhoods, or a property owner, a stakeholder, maybe you have some property with some apartments, or maybe you are simply interested in learning about what the 18th Wonder Improvement Association is going to be doing. Now, I'm showing you the second slide. This is the 18th Ward area. You'll notice there are three districts there, three census tracts, 26, 27, and 29. 26 is the Oakbrook neighborhood. 27 is the Wyomissing Park neighborhood, and 29 is the Millmont neighborhood. On the right-hand side of the Millmont neighborhood, that's the Schuylkill River that borders that Millmont area. And at the bottom, actually, it's Fritz's Island. So interestingly, this particular ward of the city of Reading is unique because, first, it is separated by a body of water from the remainder of the city. The remainder of the city, for the most part, is located all in together in one, whereas the 18th Ward, or the 18th Wonder, as we like to call it, is separated by the Schuylkill River and is bordered on the south and on the west and a little bit on the northwest by suburbs, by Kenhorst, Grill, Shillington, Wyomissing, and West Reading, which is interesting because you wouldn't know the difference. When you crossed from the city of Reading into, say, Wyomissing, you would not know that you're crossing over from one municipality to another. The reason I'm bringing that up is oftentimes I've heard over the years folks being concerned about crossing over into the city from the suburbs. And here's an example of that belying the, how shall we say, common wisdom or given wisdom. These neighborhoods are stable, they're beautiful, they're clean, the properties are well maintained, there are excellent businesses that have been there for generations, we believe sincerely that the 18th Wonder is going to be something very special. The city of Reading is unique. It's got a really interesting history. based on transportation and manufacturing, really, wouldn't you say? Transportation and manufacturing, the Reading Railroad, and so on. A lot of that industry still remains in the area, especially here in the 18th Wonder. In Millmont, you've got all sorts of businesses. You've got homes, you've got the Brentwood Industries, you've got Quaker Made, food products, and so on. And what I'd like to talk to you about is how these neighborhoods have come along over the years and what we have now and why we believe this public meeting that we're going to have is going to give us the roadmap that comes directly from you, the people, in order for our consultants to be able to do their job. Here's Oakbrook. This is an Oakbrook neighborhood. Right across the street from Berks Catholic High School is the Oakbrook Homes. Take a look at that. This is the Reading Housing Authority. I have to say, the Reading Housing Authority, which is, by the way, located right next to these. Their headquarters are located right there. They've done a really good job over the years of providing services and housing for the less fortunate in our community. And I was on my way over here tonight to the studios. I passed by another area of housing over by Carpenter, and they're just as nice. Those homes are just as nice as these. I'm impressed by the Reading Housing Authority. Very well run. The Reading Housing Authority headquarters is in this slide you'll see on the lower right-hand side. That two-story building, that is the corner of Hancock Boulevard, which is right in front of you, and Liggett Avenue, which is in the rear to the left. That's the intersection, and on the second floor of that property, 400 Hancock Boulevard, that's where we're going to be doing our public meeting on Thursday evening at 7 p.m. Please come and attend this meeting and voice your opinions. We'd like to hear about what you think the kinds of businesses you'd like to see in the neighborhoods, the kinds of issues that you have with things like parking and pedestrian safety, whether or not we have vehicles moving at too fast a speed in certain areas, those types of issues. And we need to hear from you on these. And there are going to be things that you, the public, bring up that we, frankly, won't know about. No matter how good we are, there's always something new to learn. This Oakbrook neighborhood also has some big businesses, as I said earlier. Here's a slide that shows the Reading Truck Body Works. Reading Truck Body Works is has been around for a long time. They are now part of a larger nationwide group of truck body businesses. Poindexter Incorporated is the name of the company. And Reading Truck Body is very strong and very stable and provides employment for thousands of Reading residents. And by the way, in the past couple of years, they've increased their employment by 300 people here in Reading, just in the past couple of years. And they are looking to continue expanding, and we are very happy to have the Reading Truck Body Works here in the city of Reading, and especially in the 18th Wonder in Oakbrook. Right next door to the Reading Truck Body Works is the Masano Building. This is a building that was purchased by Masano Auto Group. It was the former Baldwin Brass property. And professionals in economics will tell you that a building of that size, it's a property on 13 acres, many hundreds of thousands of square feet of space. These are called white elephants in our lexicon. And I tell you, it is not easy to flip a building that houses a very large property like that into reuse. And we were very fortunate that the Masano Auto Group decided to purchase this property. But their interest is more than just to have a larger auto showroom. They want to do something better than that. They've got an idea to do a showplace, an East Coast showplace for transportation, for automobiles, not just the automobiles that they sell, but also to do exhibits and displays, a history of transportation, so to speak. You know, cities brand themselves in different ways. Philadelphia, for example, brands itself as the place where the birth of the nation took place, the independence. And Reading has a very strong transportation history, and the Masano Auto Group is going to be focusing on that in the future. They're going to be bringing lots of interesting things to Reading, and they are one of the groups of businesses that is involved in the 18th Wonder Improvement Association. Not only do we have the Reading Housing Authority, but we also have the Berks Catholic High School, and the Masano Auto Group, and the Reading Truck and Body all have representatives on the 18th Wonder Improvement Association. Isn't that great? That's just the beginning. This is the crowd that showed up when the Masonic Order Group decided to announce that they were buying that property and announce what they were planning to do with it. They have a very strong backing and support from the general public. Here's the inside of the former Baldwin Brass Works, now the Masonic Order Group. It's huge, and it is going to be spectacular for exhibits and other interactive opportunities. People will be coming from miles around to take a look and see what's going on. This place will have displays. They'll have displays of detailing and customizing and a photo gallery and so on. It's really going to be something. Very interesting. Right next to Oak Brook is Wyomissing Park. And as I said earlier, Wyomissing Park is essentially a residential group. Residential, mostly apartments, some private homes in the upper end. And then when you get down to the lower end, it becomes more private homes. And Wyomissing Park, being one of the wealthier census tracts in the 18th Ward, has a number of people who are professionals. There are a lot of professional offices. There are some health services businesses scattered throughout, and other types of businesses that are professional in nature. And you will find them when you're actually looking for things like lawyers and architects and so on. And they're located in this neighborhood. And we're glad to have Wyomissing Park as part of the 18th Wonder Association. As I was saying, Burke's Catholic, that's right at the top of the hill here. Burke's Catholic High School is undergoing a very large expansion. I think it's around $10 million. And that expansion is going to bring a lot more activity. So one of the projects that the 18th Wonder Association is proposing is to take a look at the roadways in and around that area to see how we can help to reduce the conflict between vehicles and the students that are moving around in that area. We're talking about things like regulating some of the speed limits and perhaps putting up some signage and a few other things of that nature as a way to help improve the safety of pedestrians that are moving around the Reading Catholic. Here's an example of some of the history that exists in Wyomissing Park. This is at the lower end, and you'll find a lot of properties like this scattered throughout the lower end of Wyomissing Park. Very interesting historical properties. On the other hand, here's Millmont. Millmont is on the other side of Lancaster Avenue, as I said earlier, and it borders Alvernia University and also Angelica Park, and it runs on the edge of the Schuylkill River. This neighborhood was built for working people and for families. And you can see these nice, solid duplex properties that house families that have been there for generations. These folks are the folks that came to Reading in order to work in the mills and work in the factories and so on. And the folks that live in these homes today still are working people. These row homes, there's a point of pride in these row homes. I tell you, if you travel through this neighborhood, you will note that almost to the end, these neighborhoods are well kept. The homes are very nicely done, and their gardens are really terrific. I'm impressed by the folks who live in these neighborhoods of Millmont, Oak Brook, and Wyomissing Park. Here's another view of homes in Millmont. Businesses also thrive in Millmont. Here's an example of one, Quaker Made. Everybody knows where that is, on Morgantown Road, down right across from Brentwood Industries. Quaker Made, they've just installed a wonderful mural on the front wall, right on Route 10. Go down there and take a look at it. It's really terrific. There are other businesses here in Millmont. Here's Myers Bakery. Myers Bakery has been baking for any number of years. They're what you might call an old, venerable business. Next door to them, however, is a brand new business. See Myers Bakery down there in the background? The one that's up front, that's an old firehouse, eh? That's right there in Millmont on Park Avenue, and it is now the Oak Brook Brewery. Go over and have yourself a beer. I want to tell you more about this plan that we are doing and that we're going to be talking about at our public meeting on Thursday night. Here's an example of land uses. You notice that the red land uses along Lancaster Avenue, you can see where they are, right below the yellow. And you can see where the green parks are. And you can see that there's not much access to this 18th Ward from the city of Reading proper. There's only one bridge, the Bingham Street Bridge. So what I want you to know is that these are the issues that we're going to be talking about at the public meeting. Traffic management, on-street parking and neighborhood parking, pedestrian and bike safety, parks and recreation, design for the large avenues, Lancaster Avenue and Morgantown Road and so on, infrastructure, maintenance, zoning. That's very interesting to most people who live in these neighborhoods, the zoning and the development regulations, and also what we can do to help private and commercial residential properties. At this meeting, we'll talk about all of this. The consultants will ask questions, and hopefully you'll be able to provide some answers. These are some of the goals and objectives that we're after. As we said earlier, we're looking mostly for your input into this event. And I'm going to say it again, Thursday evening, 7 p.m., at the Reading Housing Authority, 400 Hancock Boulevard, just down the street from the Berks Catholic High School. We'll have some balloons out front so that you can see, and there's also going to be an ambassador who is going to be standing there to help you get into the conference room. This is Schlegel Park. Schlegel Park is a real surprise for this neighborhood. That's the Schlegel Park pool. We're talking about building a various different trails that will help us move forward and get people moving around. Here's the new Berks Nature Building down in Angelica Park. And please, folks, come and visit us at the Reading Housing Authority on 400 Hancock Boulevard in Oak Brook, down the street from the Berks Catholic High School, 7 o'clock on Thursday night. We need your help. We want your help. We want your input. You can even join the committee if you like. After the public meeting, there will be a survey online. I'll tell you about that at a future time. And we will have a website and a Facebook page up. We'll be able to announce that. Here's an example of an area we're going to build a new trail down to the Schuylkill River. These are some of the, if you look on the right, you see some of the ideas for rain gardens that will be in the public way. This is a very interesting neighborhood, and we look forward to seeing you on Thursday night at 7 p.m. At 400 Hancock Boulevard, Reading Housing Authority. Please come and visit us. Call me at 484-269-4902 if you'd like to find out more. 484-269-4902. Thank you very much for your time.
Mm.